Welcome, everyone, to Body, Mind, Soul Show. I'm your host, Polixeni Katsaros, doctor of physical therapy. I'm also an author of the book Posture, Simply Posture, Correct Simply. Today, I have a show that the topic of the show is called Getting to Know Your Core Muscles. So before I go on to my show and introduce my guest, Charlie, I will want to thank my sponsors. Jerry Petito, she is an author of the book, I'm Not an Addict, I'm Just an Ass. And she's also an International Hall of Fame radio show host. And she is also a health coach. So thank you, Jerry Petito. I wouldn't be here without you. She's also on HamiltonRadio.net, and this, of course, used to be her spot. So thank you for letting me have that, Jerry, and sponsoring me in the process. All right, my next sponsor is Deanne Katsaros. She's also known as Mortgage Mom. She works with Green Tree Mortgage Company, LP, and she also is a host, a co-host of a radio show, 1210 WPHT every Sunday, Good News in Real Estate. And it's 9 a.m. every Sunday on 1210 WPHT. It's an excellent show, and it's entertaining as well as informative. So Deanne Katsaros, thank you so much for sponsoring me. And the third sponsor is Direct Access Physical Therapy. It's physical therapy service provided in the home in Northwest New Jersey. And if anyone needs that and is interested, they can call 973-670-6206. All right, with that, I want to also thank HamiltonRadio.net. HamiltonRadio.net. Thank you so much, because without you, we wouldn't have this wonderful platform. Thank you. Okay, so today our show is about getting to know your core muscles. And it kind of goes along with the book I wrote about posture, Simply Posture, Correct Simply. If you know what muscles are responsible for correcting your posture, I then think that it would be simple. And of course, once we know something, then we have the ability to work it. So I want to introduce this wonderful skeleton, Charlie. Charlie comes to me from a very special colleague, Ken Grieco. We worked together in the 90s, and we are friends for a long time, even though we don't work together anymore, so to speak. We are colleagues, and we remained friends. And Charlie was with Ken Grieco for many, many years. I want to say 30 or so. And so I was able to acquire Charlie for the show. So thank you, Ken Grieco. Okay. So with that, I want to say that this week... Okay, good. Thank you. So this week, my focus is to continue where I left off last show. And last show, my topic was getting to know your muscles. And in getting to know your muscles, I spoke about the different kinds of muscles we have. And, you know, we have the cardiac muscle, we have smooth muscle, and then we have skeletal muscle. Well, today I'm going to focus on skeletal muscle. And that specifically being muscles, skeletal muscles of the core. Now, if you remember, last show I spoke about in skeletal muscle, it's not automatic. you have to have conscious effort to make those muscles work. It's not like the cardiac muscle. It works whether you're thinking about it or not, thank God. Otherwise, we would not be here. But so the skeletal muscle requires conscious thought. And that being said, I have to refer to my pal, John Assaroff, from the book Inner Size. This conscious effort that we have to make gets interfered with by our subconscious. And so the subconscious may have thoughts like, I have to contract this muscle. I have to hold it for how long? These are the types of conversations that go on in the brain that interfere with our conscious effort to make this work. So being aware that you're in control is helpful in making our muscles work. So the other parts of this wonderful core is that the core we think is located in kind of the center. Well, there's a front and a back, and there's also another important core muscle that I'm going to introduce to you today that I don't know if everyone is aware of, but it's the tongue. The tongue is a very important core muscle. And after our discussion today, after my speaking about each and every muscle, hopefully you walk away understanding how each and every one of these muscles play a role in helping us maintain upright posture. Okay, so the show is on Facebook, and I'm looking for it now. And what I see is Body, Mind, and Soul Will Start. And okay. And I want to be able to share it. There we are. Very good. Okay. So just take a moment here and let me... very good. Share this post. I'm not sure. Anyway, so you guys out there on Facebook, that's where I need to be, and I am. I'm having trouble finding it. And, you know, this is going to be a learning curve, okay, because typically I'm usually on Facebook and I'm live, and this particular time, I am on here, and I want to share it, and I'm not sure how. So I am going to not waste any more time. I'm simply going to... continue. All right, so the first muscle that I want to talk about, I'm not going to discuss them in any order of importance. They're all important, okay? So there's one muscle that I want to talk about, the first one, and it's called the quadratus lumborum, okay? I am going to stand up and show you where that muscle is. And then I'm going to come back and talk about it, okay? So the quadratus lumborum can you hear me in here, this mic? The quadratus lumborum is located at the ilium, which is the pelvis, and it goes to the ribs, okay? So it's this one actually right here. Turn sideways. There we go. So it's this one. Let me get this arm over here. There we go. So it's this muscle here. So it's a very short muscle, and normally it's located kind of where you would say, and you put your hands like this, it's underneath your hands. And from where the thumb and the fingers lie, that would be kind of where the quadratus is. And typically, we want to have three fingers between the pelvis and the ribs. So that, feel the ribs, feel the pelvis, and you want three fingers. And that would be the proper length, not like down, and as gravity pushes us, my ribs kind of sit on my pelvis right there. So we want to be able to use that quadratus and lift the ribs off the pelvis. Okay, that's quadratus lumborum, also referred to as the QL. Okay, Charlie, hang in there, buddy. Okay. So, the quadratus lumborum, as I said, it's a core muscle, and it's common, it's a common source of one-sided or both-sided low back pain. And it includes localized pain and tenderness over the hip bone, or not the hip, the pelvis bone, okay, called the ilium. Because the QL connects the pelvis to the spine, and it therefore is capable of extending the low back when contracting bilaterally at the same time. The two QLs pick up the slack, as it were, when the lower fibers of the erector spinae are weak and inhibited. Now, the erector spinae are muscles along the back of the spine, and they're long muscles, and they run along the length of the spine. One second, I'll show you. Okay, so here we have, and imagine, of course, this red string, and we have the erector spinae along the spine, like so. Okay. Right in there. And now, to be specific, it's not just one long, strappy muscle. Every couple of vertebrae, it attaches and then reconnects to the next couple. So I'm not here to give a specific origin and insertion because I don't want to bore you, but I do want you to get the gist of where these muscles are, okay? So that's the erector spinae. Okay. Okay, so the next muscle that I want to discuss is called the iliopsoas muscle, or the psoas major. And the psoas is located, and let me just take a minute and get to the right. Here it is. Okay, good. I want to read a little bit about the psoas as well. So I'm going to show you the psoas muscle is located from the femur. Okay, the lesser trochanter, so behind, and it comes onto the ilium, and it attaches to the fifth lumbar vertebrae. So It's a very deep muscle, and it is one that the only muscle that attaches the leg to the spine. Okay, yeah. All the other ones are very differently run, and it's where these muscles attach, and then it makes the direction of their movement. So the psoas muscle, pronounced psoas, may be most important muscle in your body. Without the essential muscle group, you wouldn't even be able to get out of bed in the morning. In fact, whether you run, bike, dance, practice yoga, or just hang out on your couch, your psoas muscles are involved. And that's because your psoas muscles are primary connectors between your torso and your legs. So they affect your posture. And they also help to stabilize your spine. The psoas muscle are made of both slow and fast twitch muscles. And because they are major flexors, weak psoas muscles can cause many of the surrounding muscles to compensate and become overused. So it's an important thing to know that if a muscle is tight, it's usually weak. So tight equals weak. As we lengthen that tight psoas, we then need to strengthen it, you see. Okay. So that is why a tight or an overstretched psoas muscle could also be the cause of many of your aches and pains, including low back and pelvic pain. Okay. So the psoas does lots of different types of movement, from standing and twisting and the movement that causes the leg to externally rotate while extended, such as a ballet-style leg lift. And even doing too many sit-ups, your psoas muscles complete the half sit-up. So the sit-ups are not just primarily abdominals. Yeah, the psoas is involved. With that said, but because many experts don't understand the complexity of the psoas muscles, it's not uncommon for people to be given the wrong diagnosis and treatments for their psoas-related pain. So, the psoas. Can reveal seven different problems that could arise with a psoas muscle that's imbalanced. Leg length discrepancy, knee and low back pain, postural problems, difficulty moving your bowels, menstrual cramps, chest breathing, and feeling exhausted. Wow. So there are there's a book written by Liz Koch, author of the Psoas book, and she says the psoas is so intimately involved in such basic physical and emotional reactions that a chronically tightened psoas continually signals your body that you're in danger, eventually exhausting the adrenal glands and depleting the immune system. Wow. And so there's 9 tips, she says, in keeping your psoas muscles happy and healthy. Avoid sitting for extended periods. Add support to your car seat. Lay off extreme exercise routines. Try resistance flexibility exercises. Get a professional massage. Take constructive rest. Pay attention to your pelvis. And of course, read the SOAS book. That was good. Thank you, Liz Koch. Okay. So the SOAS, I can probably spend an hour just on the SOAS, but I want to continue on the course of discussing all the core muscles. Okay, so with that, I want to then go to the next group of core muscles, and that is the abdominal muscles. Now, these are considered the axial muscles of the abdominal wall and thorax. Okay, so the muscles of the abdomen. Okay, so there are four pairs of abdominal muscles that cover the anterior lateral abdominal region. So the front and some of the sides, so the side and the front, and they meet in the middle. And these muscles of the anterior lateral abdominal wall can be divided into four groups: the external oblique, the internal oblique, the transverse abdominis, and the rectus abdominis. And now I'm going to get up and show you, okay? Okay, so we have the abdominal muscle group, which is located. The rectus abdominis goes from the pubic bone to the breastbone. Okay, and that's this long one here, right down the middle. And this one can be thought of as when people have their six-pack or their eight-pack, depending, okay? And this muscle also has some tendinous fibers that separate it out, and that's what makes the packs. And then we have the external oblique, and that goes from the ilium onto the ribs and then over to the sternum. And then we have the internal oblique that is also running along that same course but a little deeper, and the transverse abdominis, which I actually don't have here, but we can use this. And it also runs into the tendinous fibers of the rectus abdominis. So it goes across like this. And mind you, there is the same set on the other side. Okay? So that, I can probably leave that like that. Okay, good. All right. Okay, so the muscles provide stability for the organs as well as the bones and the skeleton. And it's important that we use these muscles to help hold us up, okay? The line of the muscle pull goes in the direction of the bones that they attach to. So I'm always talking about the rectus abdominis. It is from the pubic bone up to the breastbone, and that is the straight line. The obliques are also, they extend and the transverse also is deep, and they are arranged in a way that they support the torso, the core, and they also allow for rotation. They allow for some rotation, not just straight up. Okay. So I want to be able to just take a minute and connect why these muscles are important with posture, okay? So, and then we'll talk about the tongue. All right. So having Charlie here as a model, you can see that the pelvis, oh no, I'm losing him, 1 second. I guess it'll be just fine. So with the muscles attaching to the mainly the pelvis, the ilium, okay, the pubic bone, and it is muscles that attach to the ribs and onto the breastbone, the sternum, as the muscle contracts, it lifts and it lengthens, okay? So and at the same time, we're having a force down, which is gravity, pushing us. So we're needing to consciously make an effort to stay up against gravity. Okay, using all these muscles, the quadratus lumborum, the QL, lifting the ribs off the pelvis, rectus abdominis, lifting the breastbone up, lengthening the abdominal, lengthening the core, creating yourself to be taller than what do we do with the head, right? So, in the last couple of years, I've been studying the tongue, and I've been practicing teaching people how to strengthen their tongue. Well, first, the tongue is so tight, and the muscles around and connected to the tongue are so tight, that first we have to stretch, and then we can strengthen, okay? So I am going to kind of just give you a quick overview, and then I'll describe. So here we have the head, and the tongue, of course, would be in there. I don't have a tongue here, but I have the other muscles attached to the tongue. So we have the hyoglossal. Now, the Greek word for tongue is glossa. So medical terminology would be tongue, glossa. So and this is the hyoid bone, so it's called hyoglossal muscle. And there's two, one on each side, okay? Then we have the genoglossal, and that's because it's attached to the chin. And it goes to the tongue. And then there's another muscle underneath on our palate, and that's called the palatine glossal. And then we have the other muscle that attaches to the tongue. It's called stylohyoid, which is the base of the tongue. There are some styloid bones, two of them, and there's a muscle that goes from the styloid to the tongue, stylohyoid. So these four muscles, one, two, three, four, okay, attached to the tongue. Now, keep that in mind, that those attached to the tongue, especially the hyoid one, so if I took the tongue, if you all took the tongue and put it on the roof of your mouth and sucked that tongue up, it would, all these muscles from the skull and the hyoid bone would support the head just because the tongue is on
sitting on the palate just in the right way. And that would be the last piece in keeping posture against gravity. Otherwise, we're forward. So what I'm saying is pull up, raise this, lift the ribs, tongue up. And that is how we correct. And will it happen automatically? No, it will not happen automatically. We have to consciously think of engaging our muscles. All right, so now I'm going to read a little bit about the tongue, although I showed you on Charlie where their muscles are located. And I just want to say, if anyone is really concerned and interested, committed to their own body, and they want to make a difference in their posture by addressing these muscles in their body, I'd be more than happy to direct you. If you're in my area, you can come and see me. I work at North Jersey Physical Therapy, and that's in the Hackettstown office. The number there is 908-852-7575. Again, North Jersey Physical Therapy in Hackettstown, New Jersey. There's also an office in Morristown, but I don't work there. But everybody that works at North Jersey Physical Therapy understands everything that I'm talking about and further, and will take anyone to their goal of correcting posture, decreasing pain, and there's so much more that can be accomplished. So the number again is 908-852-7575 for North Jersey Physical Therapy in Hackettstown. Okay, now I'm going to read about the tongue. Okay, so The muscle of the tongue. You know, the tongue is considered a muscular hydrostat. It's a biological structure found in animals. It is used to manipulate items, including food, or to move its host, and consists of mainly muscles with no skeletal support. So think about it. The tongue doesn't have a bone in it. It is made completely of muscles, and it's made of a group of four muscles on each side. And that creates the shape and the strength of the tongue. Okay. It performs in a hydraulic movement. It's like a hydraulic movement without the fluid in a separate compartment and its hydrostatic skeleton. So it's referred, so the tongue is a muscular hydrostat. Thought I'd share that. Okay. So, you know, it often acts like the trunk of elephant. Yeah. Okay, so let me go back to the next muscles of the tongue in just a minute. And there they are. Okay, so there's intrinsic and extrinsic muscles of the tongue. Now, the extrinsic I spoke about, I showed you that there are four different muscles from the skeleton that attach to the tongue. The intrinsic muscles, okay.
there's four pairs. So they are named to the direction they travel. So superior longitudinal, inferior longitudinal, transverse, and vertical. So both sides of the tongue have that those four muscles. Okay, and these muscles affect the shape, the size of the tongue. They play a role in guiding your speech, our speech, eating, and swallowing. And of course, it's innervated by the 12th cranial nerve, called hypoglossal, of course. Then the extrinsic muscles, genoglossal, hyoglossal, styloglossal, and palatoglossal. Those all together create the powerful tongue. Now, I will say, you may have heard the myth that the tongue is the strongest muscle in your body, but it's not. It's not true, okay? The tongue is all muscle, but not just one muscle. So it's made up of the two pairs of four. So altogether, the tongue is made up of eight different muscles. Okay, and they combine to form flexible matrix similar to an elephant's trunk, like we said. And the tongue is known as a muscular hydrostat, as I read to you before. And it is one of the few organs in the body which is composed entirely of muscle and works independently of the skeleton. Okay. Wow. I bet you didn't know that about the tongue. Crazy, isn't it? So let's help keep our tongue healthy. Remember to give it a good brush while you're brushing your teeth. Drink green tea. Hydrate with plenty of water and monitor the color, which it should be pink. Okay? And that's our tongue. Okay? So, again, being able to consciously contract, yes, at the same time, all these muscles. So I'm sitting, and as I'm sitting, I am contracting the rectus abdominis from pubic bone to breastbone. I am contracting my quadratus lumborum, my QL, lifting my ribs. I am now also, you know, I am sitting, so I am not really working my psoas, although it's working, connecting my leg to my torso in a sense. But in terms of lifting my ribs off my pelvis, that's the QL, and lengthening to lift my sternum, my breastbone up. And then the last piece is tongue on the palate, the whole tongue on the palate. So as if I'm going to cluck, but I don't finish the sound, I keep the tongue up. And that could be done probably 50 times in your day. If you can really make a commitment to work these muscles, you too could have good posture. And I say this in my book, you know, if you're aware, if you have muscles, then you have the ability to correct your posture. It's just a matter of knowing. It's just a matter of knowing. So, so I want to take, it's 10 minutes before the end of the show, and I'm going to thank my sponsors again because they are the reasons why I can be here. And so I want to say thank you to Jerry Petito. author of the book, I'm Not an Addict, I'm Just an Ass. She's also an international Hall of Fame radio show host here at Hamilton Radio and as well as other stations. And she is also a health coach. And thank you, Jerry Petito. Also, I want to thank Deanne Katsaros, also known as Mortgage Mom. And she works for Greentree Mortgage Company, LP. And Deanne is also a co-host on a radio show on Sunday mornings, 1210 WPHT, 9 a.m. Sunday mornings. Okay. And thank you, Deanne. And I also want to thank Direct Access Physical Therapy. It's a physical therapy company in the Northwest New Jersey area. Physical therapist goes to the home, provides physical therapy, and the number she could be reached at is 973-670-6206. Okay. All right. So, you know, we have about 8 minutes left, and I want to open up the call in. If you want to call in and you're listening to this live, you can call in at 609-807-2492. If you have any questions whatsoever about, you know, the muscles of your core, and you can certainly reach out to me on Facebook Messenger. This will be, I'm getting used to what it means to be on YouTube. I'm not quite sure yet. That's basically, what I'll figure out as we go. All right. So I do want to, let you know that the next show is November 21st, a Tuesday between 5 and 6. And I do want to point out, though, that today is my 20th show. Yoo-hoo! 20th. And I've had quite a few, haven't I? Wow. This is my first year, and it's been going great. So thank you all for your support. And okay, so now just to let you all know, I want to read a little bit from my introduction to my book, because the message that I'm providing you today is you have to consciously engage these muscles, because they're skeletal muscles. And once you know where they are, and with a little practice, you can certainly learn to correct your posture. So my book is a guide for preventing backaches. If you understand your body's anatomy and how it works, then you have the ability to practice posture correction. In my book, I educate you about the importance of posture and the ability to correct it, as Slouch and Correct do. And those are my two characters. I have been dedicated to the practice of physical therapy for more than 30 years. Actually, it's 34 now. And focused my practice on teaching people of all ages postural correction through functional movement. And I do want to say I learn every day from the variety of patients that I do have. Everything we do throughout our lives affects our spines, and it is inevitable that we put repeated stress on our backs. My message is that you can reverse the effects of stress on your back. it is my intention to reach as many people as possible to teach the basic tools needed for a healthy back, quite simply, correct posture. First, it's important to know a few basics of anatomy, as we discussed today, the pelvis, the spine, and we didn't talk about the discs, the nerves, the ligaments, but we did talk about the muscles. So the muscles are the key to moving the spine. Our bodies are strong as long as we align our spine. It sounds easy, right? But the fact is, we don't pay attention to our spine until our muscles begin to ache and hurt. And that happens. I think it's the human nature in us. I also teach prevention because I do see somebody will come to me with a wrist problem. But if I see that their posture is off, I will take the time to teach them as a prevention. And then again, I get those patients that actually have back pain or hip pelvic pain and or neck pain or jaw pain, okay? My God, jaw pain is like red light flashes because it's like ding, ding, ding. There must be some weakness in the tongue. And as soon as they can get stronger, they're holding their head up better and it relaxes the jaw. So it's all connected. It's all connected. It's a wonderful thing. So our muscles are designed to make us move. And we don't have to think about moving since our nervous system connects all our muscles automatically. However, our life places us in situations we demand more from our muscles than responding to the forces of gravity. And this is where we have to use our conscious effort. And our bodies have a way of letting us know that our spine alignment is off or that our muscles are being asked to do more than they can handle. And that's by feeling achy and back pain. The problem is that we often ignore for too long the important message our bodies are telling each of us. So, who's responsible? You are. You are responsible. I can coach you. I can tell you all about it, but you have to do it. Absolutely. We are all responsible, though, for setting the example for our children and our loved ones all around us. So, you know, my book is out there. Okay, so the show will be ending in about 30 seconds to a minute. And I just want to tell everyone, if you don't have your copy of Posture, Simply Posture, Correct Simply, go to Amazon, click, type in my name, and my book comes up. And get yourself your copy and read it and let me know if I can help you in any way. Once again, this has been a pleasure, a great platform. Thank you, HamiltonRadio.net. Thank you, Hamilton Radio, for providing this wonderful platform. So I just want to all you to all know that the song Que Sera Sera is in memory of my mom and my dad, but mainly my mom, because she's the one that would say, whatever will be, will be.
Que sera, sera, whatever will be, will be.